See, now next topic, our topic is cell and tissue. Okay, as you already know, the cell, it is the structural and the functional unit. Okay, what do you mean by structural unit? Anyone? Why it is the structural unit? Why cell is known as a structural unit? Anyone? Anyone? Vandana?
The body.
Tell once again.
It gives its structure of the body.
Yes, okay. So it is like, see, have you seen the building? Building, see, there is the building block, brick is there, no, isn't it? So the many brick together forms the building. Even there is cement, rod is also there, okay. So that many bricks are there in formation of buildings. Similarly, see, cell is like brick. They are the microscopic brick for our body. So these many microscopic cells unite together. Okay, they form the whole human body. So they are the structural unit. Okay, so structural because they form the building block. Okay, so the many microscopic, see, cell is the microscopic structure, isn't it? Though it is small microscopic structure, many cells unite to form the structure of human body. Okay, so they are the structural unit. Similarly, it is the functional unit also. Why it is functional unit? Why it is functional unit? If you see the single cell, it can sustain independently. See, each and every cell, it has got a respiration is also there, excretion is also there. See, everything required for the cell, it will produce itself. Okay, it can do metabolism also, it can do excretion also, everything it can do. Individual cell can do this thing. So if you see the function of our whole body, actually this function of our whole body is the combination of the function of individual cell. Okay, are you getting what I am telling? See, the function of whole body, actually that is the combination of function of individual cell. Okay, so individual cell, it can sustain independently. It can perform all the function that is required for its existence. Okay, so an individual cell can do all the functions, like they can produce energy for themselves, even they can synthesize protein, carbohydrate, fat, and they can do excretion also. Okay, like that. So the function of the all cell, if you combine the function of the all the cell, that will be the function of our whole human body actually. So they are the functional unit. Independently they can sustain. Okay, they can perform all the functions. So it is the functional unit. Okay, so the human body function is combination of physiology of so the functional unit means self-sustaining. So the individual cell can sustain independently. If you combine the function of all the cells, that will be the function of whole human body. Now if you see the size of the cell, almost the size of the cell is 100 micrometer. Okay, this is micrometer, okay? Mu for micrometer. Here I have written U, that is the mu, micrometer. So 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometer. Okay, so the size of the cell, that is 100 micrometer. Okay, just imagine how small it is. Then as you already know that there are the two type of cell. Okay, so the two type of cell, they are the eukaryotic cell and the prokaryotic cell. So on the basis of this, there is the eukaryotes and the prokaryotes. The animal you can classify into two heading, or living being you can classify into two heading, that is the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. Okay, so the type of cells, they are the prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. So if you see the prokaryotic cells, you will not find the definitive nucleus there. Okay, so the content of the nucleus, they are dispersed in the cytoplasm. You will not find the membrane bounded nucleus in case of prokaryotic cell. Okay, so this type of cells you will find in the single cell organism like bacteria. Okay, then eukaryotic cells, that is the plant cell and the animal cell actually, and even you will see this type of cells in the fungus also. So the features in the eukaryotic cells, they have got a membrane bounded nucleus. Okay, but in prokaryote you will not find the membrane bounded nucleus. In eukaryotes, membrane bounded nucleus you will find. Okay, in that nucleus you will find the genetic material, DNA. Okay, that is chromosome. In chromosome there is the DNA in there. But in prokaryote, there is no definitive nucleus. There is no membrane bounded nucleus. All the genetic materials, they are dispersed in the cytoplasm. You can see in the picture also here. See here. This is the structure of eukaryotic cell. Okay. Okay.
Let me go on to this, sir. Do you think?
I have already done. Waiting. See here, in the eukaryotic cells, you can see the cell membrane here outside. See here, this LVC structure, this is the nucleus only. And inside the nucleus, you will find the genetic materials and the nucleolus. Okay, see here is the membrane bounded definitive nucleus is there. But in case of, see here, in the prokaryote, there is the non-definitive nucleus. Okay, so the all the content of the nucleus, they are dispersed in the cytoplasm, freely dispersed in the cytoplasm. Okay, so they are the different. The basic difference is that. So human cells, that is the eukaryotic cell. Okay, now we'll see that next. So this is the basic idea about the cell. Okay, so eukaryote and prokaryote. Now human cell is the eukaryotic cell. Okay, now see here, now animal cell. Okay, animal cell, that is human cell. Okay, here animal means other animal also, and human is also the animal, isn't it? So see here, the number of cells in human body, almost more than 30 trillion. Okay, we have counted this, I don't know. Okay, more than 30 trillion of the cells you will find in the human body. Okay, so in human body, see, you will find the somatic cells and the gamete cells. Okay, so the largest human cells, that is the female gamete cell, that is the size is about the 0.12 mm. Okay, 0.12 mm. Okay, so that is almost 120 micrometer. Okay, 120 micrometer almost. Okay, then the sperm, this is the smallest cell, human cell, that is 50 micrometer. Okay, so 0.12 mm, this is almost 120 micrometer. Okay, so this is the largest human cell is the ovum, and the smallest is the sperm. See, you can see in the diagram also, see, this is the, see in the right hand side below, see, this is the structure of ovum. This is the ovum. Now see the sperm here, see how small it is. See the size of ovum here, size of egg here. See, this is the size of ovum and this is the size of sperm. Okay, so the largest cell is the ovum and the smallest is the sperm. Okay, just you remember this thing. Now if you see here in the left hand side, you will see the typical animal cell. See, there is the cell membrane is there outside, there is the cell membrane is there inside, the cell organelles is there, cytoplasm is there. See, this is the nucleus. Okay, membrane bounded nucleus is there. Okay, the, see, nucleus, there is a nucleus in the envelope is there. In the nuclear envelope, there is the cavity is there. That cavity communicate with the cavity of the endoplasmic reticulum. See, the endoplasmic reticulum is also double membrane bounded structure. Nucleus is also double membrane bounded structure. Even the mitochondria is double membrane bounded structure. Okay, even the lysosome also. Even the Golgi apparatus is also the double membrane bounded structure. So, see, they are the cell organelles here. Okay, and other component, you see the peroxisome, vacuoles, microtubules, they are the, see, this is the microfilaments you will see here. Okay, then microtubules, they form the cytoskeleton of the body. Okay, individual component now we'll deal. Okay, this is the typical animal cell. Okay. Okay. Now see, in human, just we have seen the typical human cell. Now see here, in human, we can categorize the cell into two types. See, one is the somatic cell, next one is the gamete cell, and one more we can tell that is the stem cell. Okay. Okay, so we can classify basically into two: somatic cells, that is the body cell, next is the gamete cells or the sexes, and one third we can tell the stem cell also. Okay, so these are the division of the stem cell. I will tell later. Now see here, the somatic cells, so they are also known as the body cell. Okay, all the cell of the body. See, all the cells of the skin, organ, all the visceras. Okay, they are the somatic cell here. The gamete cells means only, just remember, they are the reproductive cells. They are the, in case of male, that is the sperm, and in case of female, that is the ovum. Okay, ovum. Okay, except the ovum and the sperm, all the cells in the body, they are the somatic cell. Okay, just remember. Okay, so what is the difference in the chromosome in between the somatic and the gamete cell? See, in the somatic cell, how many chromosome you will see? So in the somatic cell, you will see the 2n number of chromosome, isn't it? What is that 2n means?
No,
2n number of chromosome, that is the diploid number of chromosome. Diploid number of chromosome in case of somatic cell, isn't it? What do you mean by that diploid? Diploid means how many number of chromosome? That is 46, isn't it? 46 number of chromosome. That means 46 number of chromosome. That means 22 plus 22 plus XX or XY, isn't it? If male is there, XX, in female, that is XY, isn't it? So 22 plus
XX female.
So here
XX.
Yes, XX is female, XY is male. So this 22 pair of, this is the autosome. And XY, that is the XX or XY, that is the sex chromosome.
Sex chromosome.
CH, okay. If spelling is mistake, just you make it correct, okay? While typing, it may be mistake here, okay? So, in case of somatic cells, see, this is the somatic cells. You will see the 22 pair of autosome and the 1 pair of sex chromosome, isn't it? If female is there, XX, if male is there, XY chromosome. We already know this thing. So total number, that is the 46 number of chromosome, that is 2N number of chromosome, that is diploid chromosome. Okay. So in case of somatic cells, you will see the mitotic cell division, isn't it? So somatic cells, the intention of mitotic cell division in somatic cells, that is for growth and development. Okay. So, somatic cell, the division of somatic cell, that causes the growth and development. Just you remember this thing. Okay. Now, next thing, that is the gamete cell. So, in gamete, either male gamete or female gamete. M for male, okay. And F for female gamete. Okay. Then, how many number of chromosome you will see here in both cases? In gamete, how many number of chromosome you will see? N number of chromosome. N number means 23, isn't it? 23 means?
Yes.
22 plus? 22 plus what?
6 chromosomes.
How many 6 chromosomes? Either X or Y, isn't it? So this is the, this means this is the haploid number of chromosome, isn't it? Just I will write shortcut. Okay. So see, 20. N number, N means haploid. 2N means diploid, isn't it? So 23 number of chromosome you will see. Out of these 22, they are the autosome. And next one is either X or Y. Okay. In male gamete, you will see. Okay. Just I will copy this thing. Copy. In male, you will find. Like that, no, isn't it? So this is the chromosome. Okay. So in gamete cell or sex cell, that is the ovum. Okay. In case of this is, what is this? Even actually in case of male also, you will find. Wait. X also. Okay. So this is. Sperm. This is okay. In case of male, you will find both Y and X. Okay, Y or X. In case of female, only X. Okay. So this is the sperm. This is the ovum cell. Okay. Are you getting? Then the next cell we can tell that is the stem cell. Okay. So stem cells, they have tendency to give the other cell, any other type of cells they can give. Okay, one stem cell they can give the other cells also, all the cells of the body. They have tendency to give all type of cells of the body. Okay, now stem cells we can classify into basically other are also there. Okay, but here I have classified only three here: totipotent, pluripotent, and the multipotent. Okay, means these stem cells. They are the cells, they have tendency to give rise to any type of cell in the body. Okay. Stem cells. So they can give rise to all the type of cells of the body. See? For example, I will give, see, osteoprogenitor cell. So this is the, see, osteoprogenitor cell, it can, this, that is related with the bone only. It can only give the bone cell, okay? That is the osteoblast and osteocytes and osteoclast, okay? So, but see, if cell is the stem cell, means that cell can give the bone cell also, muscle cells also, blood cells also, and any type of cells of the body. Okay, this type of cells are the stem cell. Okay, so stem cell again we can classify into different heading, that is the totipotent, pluripotent, and the multipotent. Totipotent means if you take a one stem cell, if that stem cell is totipotent, and if you take that one stem cell, means that single cell can form the whole organism. Okay, so that type of stem cell is the totipotent. Okay, from a single cell that can form the whole the organism. Like, see, I'll give example also. See, after fertilization of male and female gamete, zygote is formed. See, zygote is the cell, isn't it? Single cell, isn't it? So that zygote, that is the totipotent stem cell. Okay, and that zygote can give the, from single cell it can give the multicellular organism, isn't it? In case of human, the single zygote cell of the human, that can give the single human being, isn't it? So see, even see after the zygote undergoes a fertilization, see the zygote undergoes division. So it goes previous division. Okay. Just I'll tell here. First I totipotent. So I'm giving example here, see. So zygote, see, this is the single cell. Okay, so during development, see, this zygote undergoes the cleavage division. So after cleavage division, it forms the 2 cell stages, 4 cell stages, 8 cell stages, 12 cell stages, 16 cell stages. So the 16 cell stress, that is the morulan. So that process is known as morulation. See, now for totipotent, I am telling. See the single cell zygote. See, it undergoes the cleavage division. Okay, the division is the holoblastic division. Equational division is there. So see, first single cell was there. It will divide to form the two cells. Then 2 × 4, 8, 12 like that. After reaching into the 16 cell stage, the 16 cell stage, that mass is known as morula. Okay, so that morula seems like a mulberry fruit. Have you seen the mulberry fruit? Have you seen?
Yes.
Yes. So that morula seems like mulberry fruit only. Okay. So see, now there is a 16 cells are there in that morula. See the, now if you take the single cell from that morula, okay, and if you develop that single cell, that can develop into a, that single cell from that morula, it can develop into the organism also. Okay, from that single cell, it can divide and it can develop into the organism. That is, if you are taking the single cell from that human morula, then it can develop into the whole human body, isn't it? So that type of cells, that is the totipotent. So the example of totipotent cells, they are the zygote is the totipotent cell, and even the cells of the morula, they are the totipotent cell, or the cells after the cleavage division, okay, of the zygote. So these cells up to the morula, okay, from zygote to morula, if you take any cell, that can develop into the new organism. So these type of cells, they are the totipotent cell. Are you getting? The next is the pluripotent cell. Okay. Now pluripotent. Now this pluripotent cell means it. Now see, this pluripotent cell cannot form whole organism, okay, but it can differentiate into other cells of the tissue. Now see, I will give the example. Now morula is over. Up to morula, the all the cells that can be totipotent, okay. Now forget the morula. See, now the morula again, it will divide, okay, and it will differentiate. The cells in the morula, it will divide, okay, for the multiple time, and the cells in the morula, that cells, they will divide into two group, okay, inner cell mass and outer cell mass. So this inner cell mass and outer cell mass, see, after the division of cells in the morula, so actually that forms the blastocyst. Okay, the cells of the blastocyst, it will differentiate into two group, inner cell mass and the outer cell mass. Okay, you can see here some cells, they will lie in the periphery, okay, that is the outer cell mass, and some group of cells, they lie inside together, okay, that is the inner cell mass. Oh, so this stage of this development, embryonic development, this is the blastocyst. Okay, now see, if you see the cell of the blastocyst, not the outer cell, okay, if you take the any inner cell, any cell, any one of these cells from the blastocyst, or that is from the inner cell mass, you can develop into the any other type of cells, okay. It can be the nerve cells, skin cell, muscle cell, kidney cells, cartilage, bone cells, any other cell, okay. So this type of cells, they are the pluripotent cell, means they can develop into any other type of cells, but they cannot develop into whole organism, okay. In morula, if you take one cell, if you develop that cell, means it can give rise to the whole organism. But this pluripotent cells, if you want to make bone cells from the pluripotent cell, you can make. If you want to make the kidney cells, you can make. That is nephron, you can make. In case of liver, you can make hepatocytes. Okay. In case of nervous tissue, you can make the neuron, you can make. But from the pluripotent cells, you cannot make the whole organism, you cannot make. Okay, that is the difference. So the pluripotent cells, they can differentiate into any other type of cells. Okay, but see, totipotent cell, it can form whole organism also, and it can give rise to any other cell also. So they are totipotent. So totipotent cells are pluripotent. Okay, but pluripotent cells are not totipotent. Are you getting? Are you ready?
No, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
So see, totipotent cell means they are the stem cells. That cells, they can differentiate into any type of tissue, plus they can develop into whole organism. Okay, that can give rise to whole organism. That type of stem cell is totipotent. For example, the totipotent cells, that is zygote is totipotent cell, and some after the cleavage division up to morula cell, all the cells in that morula, they are totipotent cells. Means if you take one cell from that morula, you can develop that single cell into whole organism, or that single cell you can develop into other type of tissue cell also. Okay, that is totipotent. Pluripotent cell means that cells you can differentiate into other type of tissue cell, but you cannot form whole organism from that cell. Okay, that is the pluripotent. Means for example, pluripotent cells, the cells in the inner mass of the blastocyst, they are totipotent cell. Sorry, pluripotent cell. Means any cell you, if you take from the inner mass of the blastocyst, that can be differentiated into any type of other cell, like muscle cells, bone cells, cartilage cells, okay, neuron, kidney cells, anything you can make. But you cannot make whole human body, you cannot make from that pluripotent cell. Okay, but from totipotent cell you can develop the new organism, that is whole human body. In case of human, you can develop the human body, or you can make the any other type of cells of human body. Okay, that is the totipotent. So totipotent cells are pluripotent, but pluripotent cells are not totipotent. Are you getting now? Now next one is the multipotent cell. So the multipotent cell, see, this is multipotency. It can give rise to the different cells of same tissue. Like in case of blood cell, if you take, there is the multipotent hematopoietic stem cell. Okay, so multipotent it can give rise to the, it cannot give rise to the other, but it can give rise to the same type of tissue and different type of cells in that tissue. Okay, now see, if you consider the blood here, see, blood has got RBC, that is different cell, WBC, that is cell, platelets, it is cell, lymphocyte, they are cell, isn't it? So see, the example for this multipotent cells is the multipotent hematopoietic stem cells. So this multipotent hematopoietic stem cells, it can give rise to the all type of blood cell. Okay, but it cannot give rise to the other, like it cannot give rise to the cells of bone, it cannot give rise to the bones of muscles, skin, like that. But it can give rise to the all type of cells of the particular tissue. Okay, are you getting? Now I saw in the picture, okay, this thing. So there is a totipotent, pluripotent, multipotent, okay. So they are the stem cells. Now see here in the one table, one chart is there. See here. See, this is the same thing I have explained here. See. Can you see here? Zygote up to morula. See, all the cell of zygote. See, this zygote, they will divide and divide up to 16 cell stages. The 16 cell stages, that is the morula. If you take the single cell of morula, any one of the cell, okay. See, if you develop the, in morula there are 16 cells. If you separate all cell from the morula and you develop, means you can give rise the new organism. Okay, you can develop the single cell into the whole organism. You can develop from each cell of the morula. So this type of cells, that is the totipotent cells. So the totipotent cells that can give rise the new organism. If it can give rise to the new organism, means it also can give rise to the different tissue also. So totipotent cells are pluripotent also. I am telling like that. Pluripotent cells, see, after the morula, see, morula develop into the blastocyst. If the morula develop into the blastocyst, the cells in the blastocyst, they are divided into two categories. They are the inner cell mass and the outer cell mass. If you take any one of the cells from the inner cell mass, you can develop into the different type of tissue. But you cannot develop this cell into new organism. Okay, this type of cells, they are the pluripotent. Now, multipotent cells, if you develop this, if this blastula goes on developing, see, now there is the formation of bilaminar germ disks, there is the formation of trilaminar germ disks. This, from the inner cell mass, there is the formation of the three layers, that is the ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. Okay. If you develop the, from the seed, now this ectoderm, it can give rise to the various type of derivative, like they are the lining membrane of the cavities, it can develop the skin also, that is epidermis of the skin also. Okay. Similarly, the mesoderm, it can give rise to the cells of connective tissue. And endoderm, it gives rise to the, again, the lining membrane. Okay. So this endoderm, mesoderm, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm, we can consider this as the multipotent cell. Okay. Here. Okay. If you forget that also, see, for multipotent cell, I have given one example, that is the hematopoietic stem cell. Okay, that give rise to all type of blood cell. Just remember, this multipotent cell, see. So now see, totipotent cell is the, totipotent cell can be pluripotent and it can be multipotent also. Pluripotent cell, it can be multipotent, but it cannot be totipotent. So multipotent cell, it cannot be pluripotent, it cannot be totipotent. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
If you further see multipotent, again we can take one more classification, that is the unipotent also. Unipotent means it can give rise to the one type of tissue only. So this is the progenitor cells are the unipotent cells. Like I have given one. Let's see, the progenitor cells of the bone cell, that can give rise to the bone cell only. The progenitor cell of the muscle cell, that can give rise to the muscles only. Means they are the unipotent, no need for you, no needed, okay, not needed for you, okay, just remember this three, okay, totipotent, pluripotent, multipotent, even there is the oligopotent, oligopotent, and there is the unipotent also, concept are there, okay, but just you remember totipotent, pluripotent, and multipotent, okay. Now one more example is there, just see here, now see here. See, this is the example of multipotent. See here, this is the single cell. This is the multipotent hematopoietic stem cell. Okay. Now see, this is the stem cell for the blood. So this stem cell of the blood, this is the multipotent cell. It can give rise to the multiple type of cells of blood only. So it is the multipotent. Are you getting? See here. From here, finally it will come like thrombocytes. Isn't it? Thrombocyte, what is this? This is the platelets. So it can give rise to the WBC also. See, they are the different type of WBC. Okay. And it can give rise to the lymphocytes also. So thus you remember from here, see, it is giving the platelets, it is giving the WBC. So these all are WBC, basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil, and monocyte. They all are the basophils only. Okay. Then next one is the, this is the lymphocytes here. And here is the erythrocytes. So see, these all are the cell of blood only, isn't it? Single tissue, blood is the tissue only. And these are the different cell of same tissue. If it is able to give the different cells of same tissue, that is the multipotent. If pluripotent means, it can give rise to the cell of different tissue, pluripotent. Totipotent means, see, this totipotent means it can give rise to the new organism. If it can give rise to the new organism, means it can give rise to the cells of different tissue also. And it can give rise to the cells of same tissue also. Okay, isn't it? So just remember this thing. Thus you remember the terminology, okay? Now the next, the component of the cell. If you see the component of the cell, see, you can classify under these three headings, see, cell membrane, cytoplasm, and the nucleus. Okay? And one more thing. In cytoplasm, see, again we can divide into the cell organelles and the cell inclusions. Plus, you add here one cytosol. Okay. Plus you add here cytosol also. Okay. So cytoplasm. Here is the three headings would be there. So cytosol, cell organelles, and the cell inclusion. This cytoplasm means, see, in cytoplasm you will find the cell organelles also. Cell inclusion means like that storage vesicles of protein, fat, lipids, enzyme, hormone, everything. These are the cell inclusion. Now one more thing is there, that is the cytosol, that is the clear fluid. Okay, the fluid, cytoplasm is fluidum, fluid is there. So that clear fluid is the cytosol. Okay, in cytosol you will find the cell organelles, cell inclusion. Or if from cytoplasm, if you remove the cell organelles and the cell inclusion, the clear fluid remain, that is the cytosol. Okay, so this is the third here. Just you put third or first. Okay, just make this table and write.